If you want to have an actual project, there's a tool that you can use. It's called a phone, and you would call your architect and your designer and they would set you up. Hey friends! Given all the ways AI is generating images and text, there's a lot of discussions whether AI is actually creative and whether it will take people's jobs. I asked myself the same question, will AI take an architect's job? Short answer, not anytime soon. But let me explain why. So this video is split into two parts. In the first one, I'm going to explain what AI can do right now. And in the second one, I'm going to explain why it cannot compete to architects anytime soon. So what AI can do right now to help architects or come in the aid of architects is to generate images and conceptual plans. And I'm going to start with the images. And the first one that I tried was basically asking the AI to generate something based on a prompt. And it gave me some very interesting ideas. Not anything that I couldn't find on Pinterest. So basically, if I was looking for initial inspiration, Pinterest would give me more. But then the second part that AI can do is to give variation based on an image. So the variation for a render is basically different options for the same space or for the same concept of a building, which dare I say is revolutionary, because this would save a lot of hours in the initial phase of experimentation. And basically what I would do here is I would try a lot of options for a space or for a building, even the ones that I consider extremely crazy, just to see how they look. And this will take a lot of time, but now, not anymore. I can just click variation on the render and I have all of these views, which is nice. All of these renders that I did were just from one tool and from a very simple and straightforward search. I didn't put too much time into it, and yet I got some very nice results. The second tool that I'm super excited about is a tool that works only in plan. So basically with this tool, the architect would set some parameters from the start, and then the AI, the computer or the tool, however you may call it, gives back some options for the parameters that were given. In some cases, these options are hundreds or thousands of them, so a lot of them. The biggest takeaway from this is that the layout adapts to what the input is, and then the architect doesn't have to manually draw every single option separately, because the design adapts to whatever input it gets. There's tools developed for this both in the States and in Europe. And as you can see in their demo videos that they have these plans in which apartment blocks or interiors of apartments, configurations, all the configurations move inside like the outer walls or the fixed walls inside, which yes, gives you a lot of options. So if you're thinking, I get pictures, I get plans, this seems legit. Where do I call to hire the computer to design my house? I have to say, hold your horses and please let me explain further. I was curious how would AI answer this question, and actually AI has roughly the same conclusion as me. It is possible that it could play a role in the design of your house, but it is unlikely that it will be able to completely design your house on its own. It even refers to human abstract skills like creativity, intuition and problem solving, extra apart from what I've said in this video. It also emphasizes that it could assist the design process by exactly what I said, generating design options based on a set of parameters specified by an architect or designer, or it could analyze data, but it is eventually at the will of architects and designers to adopt it. More on this later. If you've watched so far, I would appreciate it if you consider subscribing. That would make me very happy. Thanks. So we'll go into the second part of the video where I'm gonna explain why the computers cannot plan yet. There will be two challenges, two main challenges. Basically, the product of what they do, like the finished images or plans, refer to very, very small parts of a project's life cycle. I made a video way back about all the phases in an architecture, construction, renovation, or interior design project. And basically what these tools can do is maximum 4% of the project's life cycle. Let me explain further. So this tiny portion of a project life cycle is called the concept phase. These tools were never intended for something else. It is clearly stated that they're intended for the drafting, or the concept phase, both from the people who made them and the few people who use them. So if you're thinking, okay, but why only the concept? Why not the rest of the project? The concept phase is the only phase where a lot of opportunities, solutions, possibilities, options are analyzed in order to move forward with only one. The project can only move forward with one proposal or like one concept, one solution, one plan from all of those that are analyzed. So basically, AI can give us a lot of options, but who will choose which is the most appropriate and basically the best solution to move forward? Who will choose which will be the final one? Yes, at the beginning of a project, we have zero proposals, zero concepts, zero everything. And then we need to get to a number that we would like to analyze. If we don't have enough constraints or rules or guidelines or so on, I can imagine that the computer or AI would generate thousands of solutions, which is also not really useful because nobody has time to go through thousands of plans. So it's also super important that from the beginning or like throughout the concept phase, someone guides the AI and puts constraints and rules so that they have at the end the most relevant of all the proposals that the AI could give. So this tool gives us a lot of possibilities, but how do we go from zero to all those possibilities and from all of those to just one that's needed to move forward? That's easy. Human input and human touch. So humans, good job. And also good job for the 96% of the rest of the project that comes after this. So let's say that the concept is done by AI together with humans, because humans can do it without AI, but AI cannot do it without humans. Challenge number two for the AI would be the rest of the project cycle, which AI doesn't even touch now. Fairly. But let me explain why these renderings and these plans are not enough for the rest of the project and for actually building or doing anything for a project. So I'm gonna take three example projects that are very general. So project number one is an interior design project. So you just want a nice looking home. What AI will give you here is this rendering. That's it. What you would need for a project here would be color codes, furniture suppliers, light fittings, electrical details, of course, prices and a timetable for all of this. We don't have any of that. So project number two that I want to refer to is like a project for a completely new house. This has already way more complexity than an interior design project. What you need here from the start is by default to comply with all building codes. Actually, the makers of the planning tool state that you can put this guidelines or rules in the project to see that. But after that, all the plans need to be detailed for the building approval, so you cannot go to the authorities with plans looking like that. Someone needs to present the project to authorities. Someone needs to adapt the plans if necessary. This happens a lot of times. All these are done by humans and not likely to change anytime soon. This is just for the building approval part. Then if you go forward, you would need construction plans, which are even more detailed, managing and coordinating all the changes and all the details that come into these plans is again the great work of humans, and not only of architects but of other specialties as well, but the architect is the main coordinator of all of this. So again, I don't see this changing for tens of years from now. Project number three is a refurbishment or change of use project, which is my favorite type of project. In this case, you have an existing apartment or house or building and you would change the layout, or you would have to bring it to the current standards of living in the case that a building is super old and doesn't have heating or something like that. Here, the AI cannot even start with the concept phase without a preparation or setup beforehand, because before anything else, the existing building or apartment needs to be measured, and then that model set up for preparing the concept. And then it will go again to the building approval stage and detailing phase and so on. And then this type of project has surprises all the time. That means that new things are going to be discovered as stuff is being built, and new solutions need to be found there on the spot. So basically the challenges that come here are very complex and unique, and there's again the work of many specialties, but even more than for a newly built house. So with this one, it will take even longer for AI to take over. I cannot even imagine how this would work. It would be very complicated. And given the fact that there's not even a default design software per country, like all the specialties, also they don't even design in the same software. And as far as I've seen, nobody wants to change their software. Nobody wants to even try the newer version of a software. So even if this theoretically could work at one point, the personal challenge for humans to adapt to this would be so big, it would add like another complete, like super barrier to this. So to sum up, if you want to have an actual project and not just a rendering or a concept plan, there's a tool that you can use. It's called a phone, and you would call your architect and interior designer and they would set you up. Probably we'll get to a stage where more phases of the project lifecycle are generated, aided, or automated by an AI, and I gladly look forward to that moment because I won't have to draw like 20 toilets for a building. But we'll still have a long way to go until there, and until then, humans do most of the project and kudos to them. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it's clear. If not, let me know down in the comments if you have any questions. Don't forget to call your architect, and I'll see you soon.